Our 2018 NALCS power rankings continue, and coming in at number 8, we have got Flyquest. They've only got one member remaining from last split, and that is WildTurtle, and he is definitely going to be the featured carry on this squad.
Yeah, undoubtedly. And I mean, when you look at the roster from last year, WildTurtle was the one guy who kind of stood out as someone who wasn't really a weak link. Obviously, they had some members of that old C9 squad floating around, but overall, WildTurtle, I think he had a rebirth of sorts in 2017 summer because his spring split wasn't great. So now he's got this brand new roster around him, some unproven guys, particularly Onda in the jungle, going to be a starting rookie, sub for Immortals last year who made noise in Korean solo queue. Stunt had a bit of playing time last year on a couple different teams as well, so we'll see how that bot lane rolls around. And then you got Flame and Fly. There he is. So Fly was on in the Challenger Series last year, and then Flame, great split with Immortals, kind of the one guy who was looked down on that roster for whatever reason, but he's definitely still a solid top laner who you can kind of hang your hat on. But as you said, WildTurtle will be the guy that you look at to get some kills with.
Yeah, and despite Flame being maybe the least impressive guy on that Immortals roster, he was still a top 3, top 4 top laner last year. It was just the rest of that Immortals lineup was fantastic. I mean, this roster, I feel like Flame and WildTurtle, that's enough that can win you some games for sure. And I actually think Onda's going to perform pretty well for a rookie guy coming in. And he's really going to have free reign to do whatever he wants on this roster. The main issue I see with these guys is who's shot calling here? What kind of macro game are they going to have? I feel like that is going to be a big issue going forward. And if these guys aren't winning, doing solid in lane, these other teams with better play around the map are just going to completely crush them.
Yeah, I imagine Onda's going to be the guy to do most of the shot calling, at least initially on this FlyQuest roster. I mean, Fly, coming from that Challenger Series, I don't think his English is up to par, but they might be doing a double language communication thing with Flame and Fly, at least a little bit, and then the other three speaking English on the map as well. So I do think Onda will take the brunt of the shot calling with the bot lane pitching in and having the other guys just pitching information, but it might be a little tough at first, which could lead to some questionable results.
Yeah, and a guy like WildTurtle, obviously a veteran of the scene, been around since season 3. But on most of his squads, he hasn't really been a vocal leader in terms of communication because he hasn't had to be with the teams and the rosters that he's been on. He's been on some really good teams with some pretty vocal players. So maybe now he takes a step up as well because, again, he's a guy who's been around the scene for a long time. Won a lot of LCS splits and just had fantastic performances in the regular season. So maybe this is a guy who takes some added pressure to kind of communicate and talk to guys in-game, but we'll see.
We'll see. I just don't think that FlyQuest has enough around him, and there's a lot of question marks, obviously, on the, like we said, Stunt, limited time in the LCS, and we'll have to see what Fly can do on the LCS stage, but potential's there, just not sure if they can reach it.
Yeah, I think Onda would have to really put up a insane rookie split for FlyQuest to make it into that playoff bracket. But right now, we got FlyQuest sitting at number 8 on the power rankings.
Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more esports content.